In this video, we're going to practice drawing the polymer for this given monomer. But before we do that, we're going to spot the errors that are present in a given answer. There's no better way to learn than from mistakes. So are you ready to spot the errors in 1 minute? Here's the question. We need to provide the structure of the polymer formed from the given monomer. In fact, the polymer that we're asked to draw is polystyrene, a material usually used in packing and insulation. The monomer that is given is called styrene. Here's the given answer. You have 1 minute to spot as many errors as you can. I'll start the clock and we can compare notes at the end of the 1 minute. Ready? Here we go. Alright, time's up. If you need more time, go ahead and pause the video. So, how many errors did you find? Let's start from the left to the right. The first one is this. Notice that the second benzene ring is not connected correctly. The first and the third are connected properly, but the second one is not because the carbon bond from the polymer is connected to the bond inside the benzene ring. You can't connect to the bond in the benzene ring. Instead, we need to connect to one of the carbon atoms in the benzene ring. So that's why that's the first error. The second error is here. There shouldn't be any double bond that's present in the polymer structure. The monomer that is given contains only one CC double bond. So therefore, when we draw out the polymer, there should not be any double bond present. The third and the final error is here. In order to indicate that this structure is a structure of polymer, we need to show open-ended bonds on both ends of the polymer structure. On the left-hand side, we do have an open-ended bond. However, it's missing the open-ended bond on the right-hand side. So altogether, there are three errors. And these three errors are common mistakes that are made when drawing the structure of this polymer. Now let's see how the correct answer looks like. We start by drawing the monomer. Since the question asks for three repeating units, we draw three monomers. Then imagine the double bond from the first monomer move to form a single bond to the second monomer, like this. And the same goes to the other two monomers, like this. In reality, the reaction that takes place is a radical reaction, not the movement of double bonds like this. However, thinking this way makes it easier to get the structure of the polymer. Since we're only drawing three monomers here, in reality, there are like tens of thousands of these monomers, all connected. So imagine that there's one on the left that we didn't draw, and it connects to our first monomer like this. Having open-ended bonds is an important point when drawing the structure of the polymer. So keep that in mind. So there we have it. The correct structure of polystyrene, which is made from styrene. Here are the two videos I've handpicked for you. Thanks for watching all the way to the end. If you find this video helpful or you enjoyed it, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe. Your support means a lot to me.